What it is, guys, it's Shadana. We're back again with another video, and this one is for a breakdown of Kona 2 Broom. So this game was given to me by the lovely people over at Deep Silver. As I am a Deep Silver content creator, I'm part of the Creator Collective, and this is just, it's kind of like a first look at the game and a little bit of an information dump for you guys. So basically, if you've never heard of this game, it's called Kona. Kona is a bizarre game. It's a very weird one. It's disconnecting a royal mining village from its quiet reality. You step into the shoes of the detective Carl Faubert as he unfolds a mystery haunting the region while battling for his own survival. This game is already out, and it released on the PlayStation 5, Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, PlayStation 4. It's available on Linux, Microsoft Windows, Xbox Series X and S. And it is developed by Parable and Ravenscourt. And it is basically, the best way to describe it, is it's an adventure indie puzzle game, video game set in Canada. And the best way to describe that is it's very, very story driven, and it's a game that requires a lot of focus. Now, these aren't my usual kind of games, so I wouldn't know how to say whether it's a good one or a bad one. It's definitely something new to me, and I feel like whilst it's received 8 out of 10 on Steam and on OpenCritic, it's received 73%, which to me is not bad. It is second in the franchise, the last one being Kona 1, which released in 2016. So that's a big long time since they released a game. And it's 7 years for those who don't know. It's definitely one that's interesting, and it does seem to have a unique appearance to it. I feel like the game definitely would appeal to people who like story-driven games, like a bit of something that's a bit spooky and scary and has puzzles to it. And it's a very old school style of first player gameplay, and it's definitely one of those where it's very aware of the fact that it's there to make you second guess everything that's around the corner, and whether you're gonna die if you open that door and stuff like that. It's definitely one of those. But the way that the game starts, as you can see, it's very, it throws you in, you're on a boat, and it looks very calm and quiet, and it just gets a bit odd straight out the gate. And I feel like there is something there that could appeal to a lot of people. Personally, I wasn't sure about the game when I jumped into it, but I did think that it was a lot of fun playing it. I have probably a dozen hours into it now, and I've played it through twice. This is me playing it on my main account, and then I played it on my testing account, which I play on where I try out games that aren't really my cup of tea. And on my testing account, I've completed the game. So I feel like I'm well versed in saying that this game definitely is an odd one for me personally. I know I never got all the achievements and stuff like that. It's definitely a weird one. Player recommendations though, I would say that it's definitely one that would appeal to anyone who likes games like Outlast and survival-y, horror-y style of game with detective aspect and puzzles, and you have to solve and work out the mystery behind what you're doing and why you're there and all the crazy weird things that are going on. It's very indicative of like old school Resident Evil-y, but without the zombies trying to eat your face. And so my recommendations is anyone who likes those old school games and the scary spooky stuff, it definitely fits for its release date and its release window in my opinion. So that being said, it's definitely one that requires a final thought. It's one that I wouldn't have gone out and bought myself if I wasn't given a copy of the game. So again, thank you to Deep Silver for that. I greatly appreciate it. It's a very odd game and I feel like it's very interesting. I think this would be a great game for content creators who are looking for that spoopy, scary vibe during the Halloween-y series. And if you didn't get around to playing a Halloween-y game, this is definitely one I would recommend. It's very interesting and I feel like it has the potential to do well, but it's a smaller title and it's probably going to get overshadowed by some of the bigger stuff. And I feel like if it is picked up, it could do very well and it could be like a smash hit and do very, very well in the streaming space and content creation space. I do feel that there is a lot of potential here. That's just my opinion. Again, if you guys disagree, let me know what you think. I'd love to know whether you think that it's a good game or a bad game, if you played the first one or the second one. I am curious as to what you guys think, so sound off in the comments and let me know what you thought of it. I think that there is a lot of potential here. I feel like the design aspect and the way that the game plays is very, very charming, and it's not trying to be too many things at once. It's not trying to be a new style of Resident Evil with constant action and shooting and jumping and stuff like that. They've done a very good job of knowing where they want to take the game and keeping to that, and I feel like that is something that does shine very clearly on this game, and it's nicely done. There is a nice color palette. It does feel like it's mindful of people with, say, color blindness and stuff like that. It does seem like a game that I feel a lot of people may enjoy, but it's I feel like this may get overshadowed by some of the bigger titles, sadly, because it's definitely an indie game in its approach. But it's a good game. It uses Unity. They've done a really good job with making a good game. Again, this is the second one in its franchise, so it's definitely one that I'd recommend. As far as I'm aware, I've been told by people that you don't need to play Kona 1 to be able to play Kona 2. So bear that in mind. If you have a difference of opinion, sound off in the comments. Let me know what you think, if you disagree or agree. It's always nice to have a conversation with you guys and find out where you stand on these, because they're always definitely an interesting and polarizing game depending on people's take on the style of game. I always enjoy them. If you haven't checked out some of the other content we've done, there will be links down below or in the end card, so you've got to check those stuff out. Let me know what you think, and as always, if you get to the end of this part of the video, thank you very much for all the love and support that you give. Don't forget to like, comment, share, copy, link. It's always greatly appreciated, and I will see you guys in the next one. Safe, be well, have fun gaming. Maybe check out us live over on our live channel that we do over on YouTube, and I will see you in the next one, guys. Bye.